Now, after Carnot gas cycle, let's have a look at the Stirling gas cycle. Now, in Stirling gas cycle, we have two isothermal processes and two isochoric processes. So, you will have two isothermal processes. Let me write it down. Okay. So, these isothermal processes are 1, 2 and then 3, 4. Okay, 1 to 2 and then 3 to 4. And you have two isochoric processes. Isochoric processes. Okay, and that is 2 to 3 and then 4 to 1. Okay, so this is what is there in the Stirling cycle. You have heat input and heat rejection. You know, in comparison to Carnot cycle, it is exactly the same. You have heat input and heat rejection, you know, during the isothermal processes. So, if I talk about Q in, okay, and that is, you know, in the isothermal process. So, that is for 3, 4. So, you have P3, V3 into natural log V4 by V3. Okay. And if you talk about Q out, that is for process 1, 2, P1, V1, natural log, you have V1 by V2. Okay. So, the net work output is Q in minus Q out. So, that is P3 V3 into log, this is V4 by V3 minus, you will have P1 into V1 into log V1 by V2. So, now after this, let's get, you can say an expression for the efficiency. But let's first of all get the temperature limit. So, this is the higher temperature limit TH. And this would be the lower temperature limit TL. So, P3 V3 would be equal to R into TH natural log V4 by V3. Okay. And this would be minus R into TL natural log V1 by V2. Similarly, I can replace this P3 V3 by R into TH natural log V4 by V3. So, let's get an expression for the efficiency of the Stirling cycle, that is work output upon heat input, and that is, you can take R common from it. You have TH into log V4 by V3, okay, minus TL natural log V1 by V2 divided by the amount of heat input, that is RTH log V4 by V3. So, now we can strike off R from this. Okay. Now, let's have a look at these ratios now. Right. So, you have V2 is equal to V3, and then you have V1 is equal to V4. Okay, we need 4 by 3 and then 1 by 2. So, let's divide these. So, you will be having is equal to V1 by 2. So, this is an entirely easy thing to spot. So, all these things, they get cancelled out. So, you are left with only TH minus TL by TH, which is equal to 1 minus TL by TH, which is the same expression as for the efficiency of the Carnot cycle. So, the efficiency of a Stirling cycle is equal to the efficiency of the Carnot cycle. So, I hope you understood this analysis on the second power cycle, that is the Stirling cycle. Now after Stirling cycle, let's move on to the third power cycle, and that is the Ericsson cycle.